next series of pages come from a package that was done as a result of a project or exhibition or performance or whatever you want to call it at the Art Culture Resource Center. The project was entitled Telephone by Artist. It involved setting up a group of artists in one location in an audience at the Art and having each of the artists spend 20 minutes talking to the people at the Art about the pictures that were being shown to them while the person was talking. We have gone down quite deep into the tree structure of computer aids. Next, I'm going to recall the main menu in order to give us some perspective. Already, we've looked at the header editor, the electronic highway, personal computing, the paper page, Leonardo the video, and several packages in Leonardo the video. We're now looking at the contentrepreneur, and from here, we'll go to several more packages, just looking at the top pages of each sub-package. From here, I'm going to go back to the main menu of the contentrepreneur. There's an article in this package, a sub-package, entitled Setting Standards at Videotex 2001. I would like to show this package to you because it demonstrates one of the ways in which you can use numbers and colors in order to provide continuous depth or continuous information about specific terms of reference. For the reader instructions, I'm going to reply no in order that you can read what the reader instructions are. A simple copyright notice. From here, I'm going to go to the first page of the essay. You'll notice that Videotex 81 is in red and the number 1 is in red. I've pressed 1 to get a definition of what Videotex 81 was. I did it a little fast. I can now press retrace after reading this to pick up where I left off in the first page. You'll notice that I could also choose to get more information about Videotex standard for presentation level protocol, or I could learn more about Teledon's compatibility by pressing 3, the green number. Instead, I press next to continue the next logical page in the narrative. Here I notice Videotex goods in red. Pressing 1, the red number, I get a footnote. case, I'll continue on where I left off. I could get more information about Videotech services, but I have pressed next in order to continue the narrative. I'm now going to take us back to the main menu of Computer Ease, where the 9 packages are listed. We've already gone through the first 6. Next, I'm going to look at the first page and the first introductory page of the Videotech Vision. I'll do the same for learning opportunities, and then we'll look at games and puzzles. I should also add somewhere along the way that everything that we are looking at here in the section on Computer Ease is as it appeared at the end of 1983 when the project was closed down. Much of the work is quite dated. I'm going to go back now to the main menu again in order to find games and puzzles. It's choice 9, and that's where we're going to turn. Let's take a quick look at the introduction, choice number 1. Let's go back to the Games and Puzzles menu. There's another package which interests me. There are 3 more choices. I'm leaving out Computer Ease Crossword, which was a crossword puzzle that was in reverse. And Zazzy the Electronic Doll was another package which I'm not showing here. I have chosen a small package of 10 pages entitled Tom, Dick, and Harry. I'm going to show you 5 of these pages. What is significant about this package is that it tries to compress the most complex game into the least number of pages. With these 10 pages, I can produce 27 different endings, or 27 different faces that are constructed by pressing 1 for Tom's hair, by pressing 5 for Dick's eyes, by pressing 9 for Harry's lips, and later by pressing 4 for Dick's eyes. It can go on for a long time. Returning to the Games and Puzzles menu, this is the last page that I'm going to show you from Computer Ease. Next, we are going to look at commercial work, or work that I have been commissioned to do under the auspices of Videopage. It's time for a few more words about this video. This tape was produced by recording the composite video signal from a NORPAC IPS2 NAPLITS retrokit. The signal produced is sufficient for this demo, but it is not time-based correctable. While looking at some of my more recent work, we will run into some loss of sync. The fault lies in my NAPLITS decoder, which is unable to deal with an obscure 699 color known as transparency. video page sampler is more or less self-explanatory, even when it's transferred to tape. This package represents one of my first attempts at trying to develop the concept of the mini menu that always stays on the page. At any time, from any page, you have these four choices at the bottom of the screen. I'm just pressing next to go through, and in fact, I'm skipping over a few of the pages. In looking at the samples that are included here, I'm going to take you to the top pages of various samples without resorting back to the main menu page of this package. We're now in the Canada Council sample package. From here, I'm going to choose Special Programs. There are three special programs, and I'm going to choose the third one, entitled Exploration. For the rest of this tape, at least for the rest of this package, I'm going to let the text on the screen explain what is happening, at least until I return again. The video page sampler hasn't been updated since it was created in 1985. Since then, I have done several commissions which haven't or aren't included. The first one is Ring Music. This was done at the request of Michael McLuhan. At the time, he was the owner of the Ring Music store, and the package was designed to go on to Teleguide. This package is another of my efforts to try and develop the idea of a continuous page, a page that doesn't clear off the screen, with menu choices that always stay up, and with the ones that are colored, such as yellow for guitars, indicating which part of the package you're in, and at any time, you could press any of the other numbers, go to that section without losing your menu. At this point, the concept of pages starts to disintegrate, because really, this entire 10-page package is one page broken up into 10 pieces. The last two commissioned works that I'd like to show you are two portraits drawn for Second City Television during 1985. This one is a portrait of the Martin Short persona known as Following this is a portrait of Gus Gustafsson, another character in the TV series. These images were used in one of the regular broadcasts of SCTV. The first image was drawn by me. The second image was passed on through by me to Glenn Howard. This is the first of three packages which I want to take a more in-depth look at. Our recording, our sound recording environment has changed slightly. I'm going to forgo the radio because I'm going to be talking a lot more as we go through each of these packages. And I've also been joined by David, who will probably interject with comments occasionally. The first package I want to show you is Art vs. Art. It was produced in 1982 and 1983, and in fact, I've been working on various parts of it during 1984. Art vs. Art was an opportunity to demonstrate 21 different types of databases, or 21 different types of packages or narratives. Actually, some of them are the same. I've got things like political caricatures, adventure games, cartoons, etc. It's supposed to be a short story, and this is the first page of a story in which the Hummer sisters registered A. Hummer as mayor. This is what you would call a political caricature. Next, I'm going to press 1 to go to the next day, day 2. If you ever want to know where we are in the story, take a look at the top line of the screen where it tells you which day out of the 21 days we are in. This is another political caricature, this time of Art Eagleton. This is day 3. The interesting thing about this day, or this summary, is that it was an opportunity to put together a mock adventure game with pictures. Each page that comes up gives you one or more choices of where to go. You'll notice in this page there's a 1 in the picture at the back of the room. If we press 1, we'll go to the narrow hall to the back room and stairs. I generated this package by walking through the Cameron Hotel with a Polaroid camera and then going home and tracing the Polaroid shots into these. From here, we're going to press 1. We're now in the back room. We can't go any further into the back room, and so we're going to go back to the hall behind us. I'll press 1. From here, I'm going to press 2 to go to the stairs through the door on the right. On the stairs, I have 2 more choices. I can go to the left by pressing 1 into the hotel room. I can go to the right by pressing 2 into the Citizen Band TV studio. I'm going to press 1 to go to the hotel room. This kind of narrative is infinite. You can go on forever and ever. When you have to stop, that is, when a person can't go any farther, you've got to give them some reason why. In this case, it's because people aren't paying guests to the hotel room. Otherwise, I could probably take them into every room and address it. We've gone back to the stairs. There's David. And now we're going to take choice 2. We're in the CBTV studio. Here, we can ask to see the performance schedule and get it from Tom Cruise. This is a picture of Al Brock. this main menu of the package called the Journal Menu. We've already looked at Aristophanes for art's sake in Cameron City. Next we're going to take choice number four, called How Many Fingers? This picture was drawn by Robin Collier, parts of this picture, or A.J. Patterson, I think that's how it looks. Quite a few of the summaries are textual in nature. This is one of them, day five. It's a collection of quotes from the local newspapers, Toronto Star, Globe and Mail, Toronto Sun, about the mayoral election, and particularly comments made in the newspapers about the Hummers. We're only going to look at this page, and then I'm going to press 1 to go to the next page, or the next day, day 6. This page was created by Nina Beveridge. It's a one-page database that defines mayor and council. By pressing 1, I can go to the next day in the story, day 7. Here's a picture of Mecca, Moja Rastafari, and a little summary of what the seventh day of campaign performance was like. By pressing 1, I'm going to go to day 8. Here's a portrait of our host. The portrait was drawn by Nina Beveridge and framed with the TV screen by myself. Next, I press 1 to go to day 9. Here's another example of what I call a super menu. Each of the choices on this page stays on the page. In this case, I've chosen to go and read about Wendy Johnson. The menu tells me I'm looking at Wendy Johnson, and now I've chosen to go and look at Murniak. All the time the menu stays up. This improves the speed of the delivery of the page quite substantially. Next, I'm going to press 12 for the next day, day 10. Here is another political caricature. The portrait was drawn by Peter Smutsky, and the text in this and other political caricatures was written by Deanne Taylor. Next, I'm going to press 1 to go to day 11. Inasmuch as Computer Eve had 9 packages, in effect, Art versus Art has 21 packages. They can range from 1 page long, I do believe in a 1 page database, to infinity. The largest single summary in this package, I think, is 80 pages. Now we're at day 12, the political caricature of Ronald Reagan. next day, which is day 13. This is another text summary. There's very little graphic. Basically what you do is you prep one for what Wanda said, but we skipped it and we're going to day 14. Another text summary. I think it's about, well, this is page 106. Oh, we've gone to the next summary, but this is a mock emergency broadcast that was done or drawn or planned into the package. If you were listening to this on a computer, you would actually hear tones beeping to emphasize the emergency. It was the more serious side of the relationship between municipal government and art during this election campaign. This page was drawn by Nina Beveridge. Next, I'm going to go to day 16 by pressing 2. This is an attempt at an interactive conversational narrative. In this summary, I put in 4 questions that each viewer answers 3 times. In each case, I'm choosing answer number 1, or choice number 1. After I've done it 3 times, I'm going to end up with a quote. The quote that I end up is actually a quote that comes from, I think it was the Globe and Mail. It's a quotation of a comment that David Silcox made. But depending on what answers you gave as you went through this, you could end up with 64 variations on this quote. Next, I'm going to press 5 for the next day. Another political caricature, this time, of Art Eggleston. I'm going to press 1 for the next day. The interesting thing about the next summary is that after I'd done 4 or 5 of these political caricatures with paragraphs coming up and wiping off and coming up and wiping off, I decided that it might be interesting to try and put 3 or 2 or 4 faces on the screen that spoke in very short phrases to each other. Day 18 is probably the longest page I've ever produced. Eventually, it will end up into a conversation between Tom Tube, Barbara A. Honey, and 2 revolutionary terrorists. things about producing this package is that I discovered that the shorter you kept the phrases, the quicker things would move along. As you probably noticed, this kind of technology is very slow in appearing. Here comes the fourth character. Here's the very short phrases. You notice how much faster it picks up. Well, it probably would have been a good idea to do the whole thing with one or two words per person. Now we've gone to the next day, day 19. It was a series of textual conversations with the reader. I'm going to skip it, go to day 20, we're running short of time. Here's a summary that was taken from a piece of paper I found on a table at the Cameron. Beyond this, it's mostly text, and it tries to use the super menu again at the bottom. I'm going to skip it and go to day 21, which is the last day in the story. And here is the actual vote count that resulted from the municipal election. The Hummers got close to 12,000 votes, approximately 10% of what Art Eggleston got. And here is the copyright notice. At the end of this package, you've looked at approximately 45 pages out of a potential 250, which means that our viewing ratio is somewhere around 5-1. Normally, you wouldn't have spent this much time looking at this package. From experience, it seems that people spend an average of 20 minutes per session in an interactive package like this. The next package I want to show you is called the Database Access Report. It was produced during 1984 in collaboration with Toronto Community Videotech. I'm going to leaf through a few of the pages. The main reason why I want to show it to you is it is very similar in style and function to what I would like to do with the proposed package in my application called Bill Perry's Telephone Directory and User Manual. I've always believed that tree structure favors index narratives. That's what this whole package is. Again, I'm using overlays extensively. I'm using menus that stay on the screen. We can go to any of these six things at the top, or we can go to the main menu that's always stuck down in the corner there. Or we have, in fact, three menus on this page. I'm in hardware, and next I'm going to video text decoders. Notice that the number beside the choice disappears while you're in the choice. indicate that we're in that section of the three sections. I'm still reading about video text decoders. I think I will look at one more page about decoders and then go on to something else. The main thing that I want to show you in this package is the database directory, because in effect, that's what I'll be creating for Bill Perry's telephone directory, a directory of phone numbers, account codes, and all kinds of details needed to access databases. From this page, I'm going to go to Remote Databases, which is choice 4. I'm informed that I have 23 remote databases divided into the following categories: professional services, consumer services, free services, NAPLIS, Teledon, and Teletext. I'm going to check choice 1, professional services. Here I have a list of 9 professional databases set up for professional researchers, and for each of these I've got 1 or 2 pages which summarize the vital statistics. Here's BRS, Bibliographic Retrieval Service. Content is bibliographic listing. Its standard is ASCII. It wasn't available at PCD. And here's a page about its costs. I'm going to keep leafing through this part of it to look at other database services. CanAll. Kentel was free. CompuServe. Dialogue. The last package I want to show you is my most recent work. It's entitled Pictures of Democracy. It is not an interactive package, and in that sense, it's self-explanatory. It was done during the second involvement of the Hummer sisters in the 1985 or 84 municipal elections. I'll just let this run through without any comment. concludes my demo tape. Before leaving, I want to make one more comment about the video in the tape. If I had wanted a time-based correctable image that could be edited and wouldn't lose sync as it has been during the demonstration, what I would do is recall these pages at Trinity Square Video using Doug Back's RGB to NPSC encoder. I hope you don't mind that I haven't made that more expensive choice in order to do this demo tape. I also hope you don't mind that the soundtrack is very rough.